average of 96.41 miles per hour. Second fastest on the Yoshimura Suzuki with a time of 1 minute 10.311 seconds, a speed of 98.01, it's number 34, Wes Cooley. And the fastest qualifier on the pole position on the inside of the racetrack, number 8, Honda's Freddie Spencer, 1 minute 9.493 seconds, a speed of 98.71 miles per hour.
Right into the lead goes Wes Cooley, just ahead of Freddie Spencer and David Aldana. Coming down towards turn three is number 34, Cooley, David Aldana, Freddie Spencer, Klinsmann, and number 88, Roberto Ciarci. Let's see it from David Envy's point of view. David?
Wow! It's going to be harder than I thought. Racing and talking at the same time.
At the corkscrew, it's Cooley first with Freddie Spencer now ahead of David Aldana, then Harry Klinsmann and Roberto Ciarci. Although it's hard for David Envy to talk, let's look at it from his camera.
Into turn eight, it's still Cooley with Freddie Spencer right with him. Then there's a little bit of a gap between them and Aldana and Klinsmann, with Roberto Ciarci following up near the end of lap one. So the race has taken shape with Cooley and Spencer charging for the lead. Now Donna and Klinsmann within striking distance. The other favored rider, number 21, Eddie Lawson, who recorded very fast times in practice, is back in the 12th spot at the end of lap one.
Cooley needs to make his presence felt to put him in a good solid position towards the championship, but I don't think young Freddie Spencer will give him any ground. In fact, look how close Freddie is staying with Cooley as they thunder towards turn three at 150 miles per hour, and almost in unison, their knees graze along the asphalt. Ahead of Spencer, up towards the corkscrew. It's almost like Spencer is waiting to pounce as they flick these sleek but heavy machines from left to right. Spencer is going for the inside and trying to pass Cooley towards turn seven, and they're side by side. But Cooley, who has the inside line, is holding on.
What a tremendous start to this race, and what a fight these two are putting on. Already they have 3 seconds between them and third place, David Aldana. So at the end of lap two, it's still Wes Cooley with Freddie Spencer now literally breathing down his neck and looking behind him towards the rest of the field being led by Aldana.
Cooley and Spencer through turn two and accelerating to 150 miles per hour. And Spencer is right there, and he's going for the lead as they go into turn three. And he outbreaks Cooley. Freddie Spencer goes into the lead. Let's go to David Envy.
Third, it's hard to keep up with the leaders with the camera equipment on the bike. I can't get my body low enough to the gas tank to stay out of the wind.
Eddie Lawson, number 21, looks like he's in trouble. He's been looking down at the engine. Lawson was 12th at the end of lap one. Now he's running 7th here on lap three, but the bike's not running like it should. It's still 18-year-old Freddie Spencer in the lead with Wes Cooley right in his slipstream as they accelerate out of the 15-mile-an-hour turn nine. Spencer and Cooley pulling away from everyone else. At the corkscrew, Eddie Lawson still sitting in seventh place. He's again looking down at his bike, and it looks like he's going to pull into the pits. That'll be the end for number 21 today.
Fast Freddie Spencer, number 8, now has pulled about an 8-second lead over number 34, Cooley. We have a microphone on Cooley that hasn't worked until now. Wes, if you can hear me, can you let us know what's happening?
Pretty outbreak me going into turn 3. I tried to stay up with him, but my tire's getting a little slick right now. I think it's better that I stay here in second place and don't crash. If I step out too far, I might end up throwing away in one of these fast corners. The one thing is for me to finish this race.
But Cooley is not one to give up easily. He has the tempered style that only comes with a lot of experience.
David Aldana, number 109, has been racing for 14 years and who has successfully made the transition from dirt tracks where the bikes spend most of their time sideways to the road tracks where one isn't supposed to get sideways. But Aldana, who's a great crowd pleaser, will often oblige his fans by putting that 450-pound monster on the very edge of its tire. Aldana's in third spot. Freddie Spencer, leading, who at 18 already has almost 10 years' experience as a racer. Notice the ease in which Freddie handles that 140 horsepower. In terms that you might better understand, that's the equivalent of putting an Indianapolis race car engine into an economy car.
Freddie Spencer, the second of these three riders, is now starting to lap the back markers. Watch how he threads his bike around the slower rider, always leaving enough room in case the slower rider falls off. Well, almost always, you are witnessing an expert at work.
Those are Wes Cooley's mechanics. It's hard to tell whether he's confused over Freddie or Wes. It's not like Cooley to let Spencer get as far ahead as he is. But then again, as we heard earlier, Wes Cooley's in it for the long haul. It's championship points that brings the big money, not just winning one race. And he's still 20 seconds ahead of third place Dave Aldana. David Emby is still laboring with his extra passenger, our camera. And if you can hear me, David, come in and let me know where you are.
Here's the back of the course accelerating up the hill. Concentration is a big thing at this point. If you relax just for a second, that's when you get into real trouble. Wes Cooley is just ahead of me at this point, but he's going really fast, and I won't be able to stay close to him for long. At these speeds, you don't have much time for anything that's going on outside of the track. The corners come up much too fast, and I must keep my eye on the tachometer. Too much over the red line, and the engine will suddenly turn into a spectacular junk pile. Since it's hard to be competitive right now, maybe I'll show you something special. I'm coming out of turn 9, I'll pull a wheelie for you. That doesn't win races for you, but it sure is fun, and the fans love it. One of the hardest things for a non-motorcyclist to understand is how we keep the